Hi folks, Joe Johnson. We're at Holiday World of Katy in Katy, Texas. Today we're going to do a walk around of a little retro unit. It's a Whitewater Retro by Riverside RV. Nice little unit. Only weighs in at 2,760 pounds, towable by most vehicles. Walking around towards the front, we've got a nice little tread plate down here, rock guard. It's going to keep the main unit from getting all chipped up and dented. These units are all aluminum framed, welded aluminum framed, and they also have a heavy aluminum exterior on them. They're not the soda can or beer can that you find on most units. So that is a little bit better built unit. And then up on the front, we do have a rock guard for the windows, a little protector, which makes it nice to be able to get some sunlight in there, and it is a little tinted window up on the front. We also have two 20-pound propane bottles, and then we also have a battery up front. Coming around on the curb side of this unit, for only being 18 foot long, there's a lot of storage in here. You have some exterior storage down here, and then we do have a 110 and propane water heater on this unit. Easy accessible dumps for your gray tank and for your sewage tank. And then on the back, we also have our refrigerator vent, our city water connection, so if you're hooked up at a RV park, you can go ahead and get city water. Or if you're just traveling down the road and want to carry a few gallons with you, you can fill up your potable water. That way you can go ahead and flush the commode, wash your hands, do any miscellaneous stuff you'll need water for. And then we have a real nice, probably about 25 foot power cord here, 30 amp service. And then it does have an exterior cable connection, so you can hook up to cable TV or a satellite dish if you'd like. Gotta love the little moon wheels we have on here. They're 14 inch tires. And it does have a torsion suspension, independent suspension on this, so it pulls real nice going down the road. Then again, you have your darker tinted windows. How we're camping now, we have a nice big awning, a lot of room under here, table and chairs, and you're outside enjoying the campground area. We have the back of the AC right here. The vent hood actually vents to the outside, so if you're cooking inside, it'll exhaust all those fumes out of here for you. And there's also a nice little 110 connection here. Easy accessibility to it. Let's go inside and check out some of the storage and amenities on the inside. On the inside of the retro here, we have windows on both sides of the unit and one in the front. The side windows will open up so you can get some fresh air through here. Real nice little feature there. Also, good size storage in the back here. Accessible from the exterior or interior. Put a lot of stuff inside of there. And then the table naturally does make down into a bed. So you do have a second sleeping area, but one of the little features that I like is it slides back and forth. So if you're a little bit long-legged or big, easy in, easy out. And then it also has a 110 outlet right here. And then coming back around to the galley area, as I'm walking down through here, I want to point out this is an all vinyl floor, so they take everything into consideration, the ease and convenience of keeping it clean, functionality, easy to maintain. Over here on this side, we do have our wet bath, the all-in-one shower toilet area. Plenty of room on the inside though. Folks, you got to remember, this is a lightweight unit and it only is 18 foot long. And then opposite of the door in the galley area, we have a nice sized refrigerator with freezer compartment. It does work off of 110 and propane. And above that, we have storage. Good little storage area right here. Anybody that's familiar with camping knows that there's never enough storage in these things. But Whitewater Retro has a lot of storage in it. And then over on your back wall, you have a nice mirror. A monitor panel to tell you how much capacity you have in your holding tanks, and then your furnace controls right there. And then coming around towards the back, we have more storage in the back, and actually another window that you can open up to get cross ventilation, another one right across from that. A lot of storage. Again, you can hang, hanging storage and all kinds of room. And you do have your little reading lights up on the top, and you do have 110 outlet up here also. Good sized RV, queen sized bed. And again, more storage up underneath the bed area. And then we have our air conditioner right up on, mounted on the side, so it's gonna keep it a low profile unit for you. Again, the lower the profile, the easier to pull on here. And then we do have good sized cabinet space up on the top up here, and a microwave oven. And then we have a countertop over on this side, and a little bit more countertop extension on this side with your two burner propane stove. Drawers, easy accessibility. We've got three drawers right here, and then the furnace unit mounted on the below the drawers. And then you have also good storage up underneath your sink area here. And good size little sink area here to do pots, pans, dishes, miscellaneous stuff. And then we do have our lights for the interior and exterior of the unit. Folks, that kind of concludes our short walk around here of the little 18-foot retro. Like I said, only 2,760 pounds, easy to pull. If you watched and enjoyed the video, interested in seeing one of them, come down and see us at Holiday World of Katy. And don't forget to use the promo code JJR. I'm Joe Johnson. We have promotional benefits attached to that promotional code. So please give us a call or come on down and see me. When you go, go, go.